Everything's all right. Everyone's happy. People are at a park. Everything's all right. But what happens when things go bad? What are people going to do? You can't just get on the phone and call the police, the fire department. You'd be scared to go to the park. You don't know what's going to happen. You can't just drop your kids off, play lacrosse. What happens when things go bad? People ask me, why do I prep? Well, ask them, why do you get up in the morning? You know? Prepping is not, it's not new. It's been around a long time. When I told my father what I did to my Jeep, I showed him my videos. He said, okay, that's nice, but that's nothing new. You know, when I used to go shopping, I used to buy, you know, a screwdriver. I don't buy just one. He buys two or three when the price is right. He just, you know, he gets it. And my mother used to go shopping. She didn't buy one loaf of bread. She bought two or three. Had a refrigerator in the kitchen. And we also had a freezer down the basement full of meat. That's just something we always did. A lot of us did that back in the day. But now people label it us preppers, which I'm fine with that. I like the name prepper, really. I tell people, SJ, survival gene. They're like, survival gene? What are you going to wait for? Something to take over? No, no, it's not about that. It's about if I need something, I can just go to my Jeep and get it. Something simple. You know? Like this one guy, his battery went dead in his truck. He asked me for a jump. Now this one guy is always asking me, oh, you're wasting your time, this and that. And when he asked me for a jump this morning for his car, I said, I thought I was wasting my time, and I drove off. When I got out for work, he was still there. He's pissed at me because I didn't give him a jump. But you were making fun of me like for a month and a half. Now he knows. He said, I guess it's not a bad idea to have a little something extra. No, it's not. I ain't missed a day's work. It's because he couldn't get a jump. I'm not to rely on someone. That's the whole thing about being a prepper. You don't want to rely on other people to help you out. Now the SJ has a bearing problem. It's making a little bit of noise. So while I'm in there, I might as well do the U-joint too. I did the other side. So I can do that really any time. I can jack it up and just pull it apart. Now something I do with the SJ, that I'm going to share with you guys, when I take it apart, I'm trying hard doing this with one hand. When I take a nut apart, I use this. Copper anti-seize lubricant. Put that all over my bolts and nuts. So, pretty soon my whole truss couldn't be like that, lubricated. So when I do have to take something off, it's easy to come off. My spark plugs, I put on my spark plugs, so they're easy to come off the next time I do a tune-up. That's something I did when I used to work in cars. Our shop used to do that with every car that came in. They don't do that anymore. You bring your car to a shop, you never see someone put that on your lug nuts or your tuna, your spark plug. They don't do it. You know, it slows the process down. They want to make that fast dollar, go to the next car. Back in the day, late 80s, early 90s, it wasn't about how fast you could do it. They want to do the job right so you can come back. Because when your car goes to another shop and that shop sees all this lubricant anti-seize on your nuts and bolts, I'm like, wow, who worked on your car? You know? Well, that's a bin I have just for the SJ. That's just stuff I have. And at first I took it out because I didn't need it today. My kids, I think they want to do something this weekend, so I think I'll put it back in for them. Anyway, back to what I was saying. It's crazy. What are you going to do when WRL hits and you'd be scared to go outside? You know, you can't just walk around, drive around with your windows down. You never know what might happen. So it's, prepping is not nothing new. They just labeled it, which is fine, you know. I'd rather have a little something now than nothing later on when you need it. You know? Could you imagine if the electricity went down for 2 weeks? People would lose their minds. You know, start stealing from each other. It's crazy. Just having a small battery bank in your house, in your car, your garage, your shed could do a lot for you. You know? And I was just thinking about this. People who could afford to buy a boat or a motorcycle, you know, some luxuries. Don't buy that boat. Take that $10,000 or whatever boat might cost and buy a bank of batteries and a solar panel on your roof or something. You know, buy $10,000, you can get a nice setup. And a boat you can't use all the time. You know, once you got it, you can't just sit there in your yard. Your batteries and solar panels always working. You know, a generator is nice to have in your house, but you also need gas. How many of us are going to have gas? Most people who have these generators don't have gas. They have to go to the store and get the gas when they need it. Now, when electricity goes down, everything goes. The gas station don't have no gas, so how are you going to get gas from your generator? Solar panel is always ready. Batteries always topped off. The thing about your batteries, you can't just charge up everything in your house. Certain things. My advice to you guys is LED lights, grab them. I mean, they go a long ways. Put a couple of those in your light in your house, and your batteries will last a lot longer. As far as my survival Jeep, I didn't make this so the end of the world comes, I can hop my Jeep and I'm all right. No, it's not about that. I just have some certain things. You know, some things my parents always had. First aid kit, flashlight. Yeah, I had the batteries and the solar panel because at first I thought it was pretty cool. And you don't even notice it. You know? Right now, the sun is not out. The sun is going down. My batteries are topped off right now. I'm pretty sure. I didn't even check. Let's check it. Let's turn the switch on and see what we got. Topped off good. And we have 25 watts coming in at one amp, you know, almost 2 amps. Watt peak was 75 watts. So, see, I got the switch there. I had to charge my batteries if I have to. See, like I was saying, another thing too is have these in your truck, in your car. So when you work on your car, you can put these on. You know, so you don't get your hands dirty, muddy, or greasy. Buy a box of these, throw it in your car, your truck, so you might get a flat tire. You'd be surprised, change your flat tire, how dirty your hands will get. You might say, ah, no big deal, your hands are dirty. But if you have to go to work, you know, you don't want to go to work with dirty hands. You know? Just helps. Little things like that. Doesn't cost much. And I told my father, you know, I think about all the things you taught me, and I appreciate it. Because today, we don't teach our kids that same little thing that you taught us. You know, it's crazy. I don't know where the world is going to, man, but A lot of our kids are spoiled today. You know? I know some kids, they have Xbox, the new Xbox, and they have the new PlayStation, and they have the new Wii. There's no way in the world my parents would borrow all that stuff for me. I had to be on Christmas. I mean, my birthday. Christmas would get a big present like that. Now kids today, they have 2-3 bicycles. They got Wii, PlayStation, 6, 7, 8 games. How much those games cost? It's crazy. You know, a lot of kids are driving to school in new cars. That's crazy, man. You see this? The car, my first car, I had to tow it home. It didn't run, neither transmission. You know what I mean? Right now I'm at a little park. People, you know, having fun. What happens when that fun stops? What are you going to do? These kids are very smart, all of them. But they rely on computers. They can't even... I asked this one kid to help me build something. I gave him a hammer. He looked at it. He didn't know what it was. Took him all day to hit one nail. Are you kidding me? That shows a lot what his mother and father teach him. You know, it's... I don't know. It's sad. It is really, really sad. You know, they have this thing where... I was watching this, these kids play softball, or softball team. And it was ridiculous. When I was on a softball team in elementary school or middle school, I mean, you try to strike the person out. And if they strike out, you get laughed at. You know? That's part of growing up. You know, you go home and you practice again. Today, the parents today, they hire people to help their kids. What's wrong with getting your butt out there and helping your kids yourself? It's crazy, man. It's sad. And you know what? It's our fault. If you're 40 and up, it's your fault, man. Because my parents never had to hire someone to help me do something if I struck out. And if I struck out, if I was on a softball team or when I was older, I got on a hardball team, my father took a day off of work. And he'd come see me play. And I struck out, he'll say right out. You know, he'll say it. He'll say, you know, I took a day off to see you strike out. You know? Kids today, man, they strike out. Their parents say, oh, it's okay. Pat them on the back. Get out of here, man. It's okay. You struck out. The team lost because you can't hit the ball. Every time you get up back, you strike out. You can't. Can you imagine telling your kids that? I do it. I mean, my kids, I have girls. And one runs track. I say, I tell her, hey, get out there, do the best you can. You know? Put your eye in the first person. Someone pass you, pass them back. All right? Because there's first and second place. After that, you lost. That's how life is. You go to your job, you do good, you get raised, you get promotions. Your boss is not going to say, you know, it's okay. No, it's not like that. I'm hard with my kids because the life is hard. It's not, no, oh, it's okay. You know, there is no losers. No. It's first place or you lost. That's the way it is. That's why people practice. But the kids today, man, it's not their fault. It's the parents. Or it's patting them on the back. It's okay. You know, you'll get them next time. You know, I know this one school, they're always in last place. But you see their parents driving up with BMs and Mercedes, and they got the new whatever kind of sneakers. But their kids, they playing out, they suck. They straight up suck. Because you can't buy everything. You have to earn. You have to work for it. You know? Last time I went, where'd I go? I don't know. I went to a school meeting with my little one. You know, she's in elementary school. And I said, the teachers, you know, not teachers, but the parents come up to me and say, you know, Your kids are going to do really good on honor roll. Wow, how do you do it? How do I do it? My kid's been on honor roll since elementary school. My other one's in high school. Honor roll, because I tell my kids 90 and up. If you want that $300, $400 cell phone, I'll buy it for you. But I want to see those scores 90 and up. You're not going to come home with a 65, a 70, 80. That's not working in my house. You know, I didn't do good in school. You know, so I know what the struggle is about. I want my kids to do better so they have a better life than I do. Anyway, what the parents were saying, how do you do it? Well, for one thing, when I go home, I try to help my kids with the homework. I don't wait until they're in 8th grade, 9th grade and try to help them. I try to help them in elementary school. Once you get those 80s and 90s in elementary school and middle school, high school, it's like a walk in the park. You know? And the parents are telling me, oh, well, you know. No, it's not, oh, well, you know. When you go home, don't pick up the bottle and start drinking. When your kid's upstairs, you know, struggling. Or outside till 10, 11 o'clock and trying to run inside doing his or her homework. I tell them this right in the meeting. Every time we go to a meeting, they see me there, they put their head down. Because they know not to say nothing to me. Because I tell them how it is. Your kids will do a lot better if maybe if you help them. Okay, stop buying these expensive cars. Try to get a tutor. You know what I mean? I tell them how it is. Are your kids acting up in school? That's the teacher tell them. I mean, you know, little whoever it is, and I forgot the little kid's name. He's like 15, acting up in school. You know, it's not the school's fault to raise your kid, okay? And they asked me, what would you do if your girl's acting up at school? They don't want me to come to their school, believe me. I will embarrass them in front of their friends. All right? My kids know what punishment's about. Did I spank my kids? Yeah, of course I did. I don't have to do it no more because they know. When daddy comes to the school, oh, there's a problem. See, the problem is the kids today are not scared of their parents. I don't hit my kids. I don't discipline them. You know, you go out and buy them things, and there's one lady. She bought her kid, I don't know, some expensive, like $200. I know that kid is struggling through school, and I would never, ever buy my kids something. They're struggling in school. I just wouldn't do it. But people today, they want to buy. Can't buy love. I think that's a song. But it's true, you cannot buy love. It's crazy. I just want to get this out there. You know? I mean, I see some of these kids, it's sickening, man. I live in a complex, and I get all the kids together. Let's have a kickball game. Can you believe I threw the ball, I rolled the ball, and this kid missed the ball? He's not holding the bat. He's kicking it. He completely missed the whole ball. All right, so I know, big deal. You got to see these kids, bro. I asked him, don't your parents ever play with you guys? Dude, no. I'm like, really? They don't do nothing with you guys. No. My dad comes home, he just goes downstairs and he drinks, or maybe he just watches a football game, basketball game. No. Like, wow. All right, so tomorrow, everybody got a bicycle? They say, yeah, okay, get your bicycle, we're going to go riding. You know, let's go around the park. My bike doesn't work. Your bike doesn't work. Kid got a brand new Cannondale. I don't know if you guys know what that is. It's an expensive bike. Flat tires, the chain is all rusted. I'm like, wow. Kid doesn't even know how to ride it. He's like 16. I'm like, wow. Okay. When I was younger, man, my parents bought me one bike. After that, I had to make my own. I couldn't come home and tell my parents, oh, some kid took my bike. Oh, yeah? Well, go back there and go get it, because I'm not going to buy you another one. You better come home with that bike. That's what my mother told me. You know what I mean? kid today, man. Oh, my bike got stolen. Okay, we'll buy you another one. Now get out of here with that. Are you kidding me? Anyway, man of many things. Then I call this a little powwow talk. How things was and how things are now. It's sad. That's why we prep. Because preppers know that's not always going to be like this. You're not going to always go to the store and get something. You know, life might not be on all the time. What are you going to do if all this ends? Anyway, a man of many things. And I hope you got some out of this, because I sure did. Talk to you later.